Hi. So we are now on to the next question in our list. We talked about the need for triage, the ability to figure out whether it's perfectly fine, whether you can do a small change and it will work, or whether it really requires expert help. So that is our triage part, and that's how we figure out how to make sure that we avoid catastrophic failures. The next thing is, in order to do this, we have to, I mentioned that we needed to create an idealized physical model for a structure. Question is, how do we do this? How do we create a simple model for a complicated structure? So let us see if we can do that in some clean way. So that's where we are headed in this question. So creating simple models okay by model I don't mean a small version like what you would think like a model airplane. What I mean is a mathematically simplified representation. The actual word is cartoon. Like a cartoon, we will exaggerate some features and we will suppress other features so that it has some ability to represent the actual thing. We are now unable to actually represent the full body. It is way too complicated. So that's why we go for cartoons. How complicated our cartoons are depends upon our ability to actually deal with some of the mathematical problems. Okay. So in fact, this is what your science classes help you do. In a very fundamental way, your science class equal to engineering cartoon making. I mean, you never thought of a science class that way, did you? But think about it this way. Let us look at your physics class, right? We talked about particle. You know, if you look at a particle, I mean, you cannot show me a particle in real life. It doesn't exist. We can model things as particles, which is a cartoon of something. What is it a cartoon of? So think of what a particle has, okay? It has location or position. That is one attribute. What else does it have? It has mass. Okay, that's the other attribute. And hence it can store momentum. That is its speciality. It can store linear momentum. That's what it can do. Okay? Of course, you can say, what about kinetic energy? Look, energy is a very vague thing. Okay? Everything will store energy. Even you or even my laptop, even my my webcam, they store energy because they can be hot or cold or something. So energy storage is not a particularly distinguishing feature. Okay, so on the other hand, what a particle can do is it can store linear momentum. So if you want to get back linear momentum, this is what you should do. You should store it in a particle. The next item, and particles from an engineering point of view, particles are not terribly useful. They are convenient for some purposes, but on the grand scheme of things, they are not really that useful. The most important thing is rigid body. It has position and orientation. Right? It has a location. You can say where's the center of mass of the rigid body and which way is it oriented. And it has mass and inertia or rotational inertia. Now this thing can store momentum, linear momentum and angular momentum. And it can transmit forces. And in this case, it can transmit forces and torques. So, a particle can store momentum and it can transmit forces. A rigid body can store linear and angular momentum and it can transmit both forces and torques. This is what it can do. Okay. Now we come to our, up to now we have only looked at rigid objects. Then we come to our classic thing called spring. In fact, it should be called ideal spring, because spring is also the name for a mechanical part, and an ideal spring is a little bit more than the actual mechanical object. Okay. So now ideal spring does not have mass. You can see already it is not really a spring. You know what I mean? It's an ideal spring. It does not have mass. And interestingly enough, what it stores is kind of interesting. What it stores is deformation or displacement. It can also transmit forces, because one end of the spring, so imagine here is the spring, right? The force on this side, F1 and F2, F1 equal to F2, and so it transmits the forces right through. But what it does is, it enables you to store displacement. So if you think about a switch, you know, when you turn it on, it will store that, and then when you switch it off, it will come back and it will remember its old one. You see what I mean? So in fact, a spring has a memory of its old configuration or its old shape, and you can always get back to it. That's what I mean by storing displacement. Okay? And these are all ideal models. Using springs and masses, you can create ideal models for all kinds of things. So I can create spring, mass, spring, mass, like that. And I can make a simple multiple degree of freedom system, which can reflect certain useful things. Then we have ideal cable. And this one does not store anything, but it transmits both displacements and forces. Because if you think, actually not any force, but actually only tension. So you can take ideal cable, and if you pull on one side, the other side will pull. So it will transmit the tension. Okay, and at the same time it will transmit the displacement. If I pull on this, it will pull on the other side. You see what I mean? So that's an example of an ideal system. And notice I am using the word ideal, because there are real cables which are actually somewhere between an ideal cable and a spring. Okay, they will not really do what you expect. Okay, but an ideal cable is one that cannot be extended. Okay, and usually technically they're referred to as inextensible cables. But people are pretty casual, and these are all cartoons, models. And by combining them in different ways, by attaching them to each other, you can create much more complicated things. Okay, the next model we are going to look at. Now we are coming to the main model. This is the one that we are going to use. It's called a rod or beam. Looks roughly like this, and now you can transmit all kinds of things across it. You can transmit moment, force. You can transmit both forces and moments through it. It will bend, it will twist, it will do all kinds of interesting things, and by combining them together you can get a structure. So this is our basic element. We will not really use any of these other things all that much. We will use particles sometimes. Okay, but this subsumes most of them. It combines the features of particles. It combines the features of springs. It combines the features of cables, all kinds of things. This is our minimum unit. This is what we are going to use to model all kinds of things. Let us look at an example and then you will see what I mean. Okay, let's go up here. So here is a good example. Is it obvious to you? I mean, in this case, it's a very trivial one. So I can model the pole vault, the pole of the pole vault as a bar, that rod. The interesting thing is I can also model the person as a rod, but not as one rod, but maybe multiple rods. Can you see? I can model this person like this. So here is the rod, here is another one, here is another one, here is another one, right? Here is the rod for the body, and here is the rod for the leg. So it looks like a stick figure. But for all practical purposes, this is good enough. In fact, I may have actually even rod for the individual portions of the leg. But I want you to understand that I can actually model this person with the pole entirely as a sequence of rods. Different kinds of different dimensions, but it's a rod. If you look at a bridge, I can model it rod, cables. So I can do combination of cables and rods. I want you to understand that to a structural engineer, the whole world looks like bars or rods. So we can do several examples, and I will show you then more examples as we go along, but this is the basic idea. The challenge for us is, how do we connect the rods together? Okay, so we already talked about our basic unit. What is our basic unit? Right, it's a rod. And a rod, we will talk about why it's, what are the special features of a rod and what it can do and all of that in great detail. But that's our basic unit. And then connecting rods together, I can make all kinds of objects. Okay, so we are going to do mainly stick figures of all kinds of things. Car frames, this, that, everything. Okay.